morning, and may we greet you, Bazalwane, in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Today being the second Sunday of Advent on the 5th of December 2021, coming live to you from All Saints Cathedral, this is Reverend Sigudla, bringing you the morning Eucharist service for the second Sunday of Advent. The readings for today are found on page 8 of our new lectionary, as well as page 73 of the previous year's lectionary, and also on page 150 of our prayer book. And this is how our readings stand. The first reading is from Malachi chapter 3, verses 1 to 14. And then the psalm today, instead of the psalm, we have Luke chapter 1, verses 68 to 79. And the second reading is from the letter to the Philippians, chapter 1, verses 3 to 11. And we have our gospel reading being the gospel according to St. Luke, chapter 3, verses 1 to 6. And we also have the canticle for today being canticle number 2, Jerusalem, a city of peace. And so we shall join together in our service today. The service for today commences on page 104 of our prayer book, and we shall have a said Eucharist service. The Lord be with you, and also with you. Let us pray. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Jesus said, "You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, and with all your soul, and with all your mind. This is the first and great commandment, and the second is like it, you shall love your neighbor as yourself. On these two commandments depend all the law and the prophets." And if we say we have no sin, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us. But if we confess our sins, God is faithful and just, and will forgive us all our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Therefore, brothers and sisters, let us confess our sins, firmly resolved to keep God's commandments and to live in love and peace with our neighbor, trusting in the saving and cleansing blood of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Christ have mercy, Christ have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy. So together we pray. Mighty God, our Heavenly Father, in penitence we confess that we have sinned against you through our own fault, in thought, word and deed, and in what we have left undone. For the sake of your Son, Christ our Lord, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life to the glory of your name. May the Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy on us, pardon us our sins, and set us free from them. Confirm and strengthen us in all goodness, and keep us in eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And we shall say together the collect for today, and together we pray. God of timeless grace, you fill us with joyful expectation. Make us ready for the message that prepares the way, so that with uprightness of heart and the holy joy we may eagerly await the kingdom of your Son, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. And we shall be seated and listen to the readings for today. We greet you once again, Bazalwane, in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Our first lesson, taken from Malachi chapter 3, verses 1 to 14. Malachi chapter 3, verses 1 14. Look, I am sending my messenger who will clear a path before me. Suddenly the Lord whom you seek will come to his temple. The messenger of the covenant in whom you delight is here. Here already, says the Lord of hosts. Who can endure the day of his coming? Who can stand firm when he appears? He is like the refiner's fire, like fuller's soap. He will take his seat, refining and purifying. He will purify the Levites and cleanse them like gold and silver. And so shall they be fit to bring offerings to the Lord. Thus the offerings of Judah and Jerusalem shall be pleasing to the Lord as they were in the days of old, in years long past. I will appear before you in court promptly to testify against sorcerers, adulterers, perjurers, against those who wrong the hired labor, the widow and the orphan, who thrust aside the alien and have no fear of me, says the Lord of hosts. I am the Lord unchanging, and you too have not ceased to be sons of Jacob. From the days of your forefathers you have been wayward and have not kept my laws. If you will return to me, I will return to you, says the Lord of hosts. You ask, how can we return? May men defraud God that you defraud me? Yes, you ask, how have you defrauded me? Why, in tithes and contributions, there is a curse on you all, the whole nation of you, because you defraud me. Bring the tithes into the treasury, all of them. Let there be food in my house. Put me to the proof, says the Lord of hosts, and see if I do not open windows in the sky and pour a blessing on you as long as there is need. I will forbid pests to destroy the produce of your soil or make your vines barren, says the Lord of hosts. All nations count you happy, for yours shall be a favored land, says the Lord of hosts. You have used hard words about me, says the Lord. And then you ask, how have we spoken against thee? You have said, it is useless to serve God. What do we gain from the Lord of hosts by observing his rules and behaving with difference? Hear the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Instead of the psalm today, we have appointed for us a reading from the Gospel according to St. Luke chapter 1 verses 68 to 79. We shall read and highlight this together. Reading from the Gospel according to St. Luke chapter 1 verses 68 to 79. Praise to God, to the God of Israel, for he has turned to his people, saved them and set them free, and has raised up a deliverer of victorious power from the house of his servant David. So he promised, age after age he proclaimed by the lips of his holy prophets, that he would deliver us from our enemies, out of the hands of all who hate us, that he would deal mercifully with our fathers, calling to mind his solemn covenant. Such was the oath he swore to our father Abraham, to rescue us from the hands of our enemy, and grant us free from fear to worship him with a holy worship, with uprightness of heart, in his presence, our whole life long. A new child shall be called Prophet of the Highest, for you will be the Lord's forerunner to prepare his way and lead his people to salvation through knowledge of him by the forgiveness of their sins. For in the tender compassion of our God, the morning sun from heaven will rise upon us to shine on those who live in darkness under the cloud of death, and to guide our feet into the way of peace. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. We shall now listen to the second lesson. A reading from the letter of Paul to the Philippians, chapter 1, verses 3 to 11. Okay, Bazalwane, our second reading is a reading from Philippians chapter 1, verses 3 to 11. Philippians chapter 1, verses 3 to 11. I thank my God whenever I think of you, and when I pray for you all, my prayers are always joyful, because of the part you have taken in the work of the gospel from the first day until now. Of one thing I am certain, one who started the good work in you will bring it to completion by the day of Jesus Christ. It is indeed only right that I should feel like this about you all, because you hold me in such affection, and because when I lie in prison or appear in the dock to vouch for the truth of the gospel, you all share in the privilege that is mine. God knows how I long for you all with the deep yearning of Christ Jesus himself. And this is my prayer, that your love may grow ever richer and richer in knowledge and insight of every kind, and may thus bring you the gift of true discrimination. Then, on the day of Christ, you will be flawless with blame, reaping the full harvest of the righteousness that comes through Jesus Christ to the glory and praise of God. Hear the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. The canticle appointed for today is canticle number 2, found on page 342, Jerusalem, City of Peace. And together we shall say, in the last days the mountain of the Lord's house shall be exalted. It shall be established as the highest of the mountains. It shall be raised above the hills, and all nations shall come flocking to it. Many people shall say, let us go up to the mountain of the Lord, to the house of the God of Jacob, that he may teach us his ways, and we may walk in his path. For out of Zion shall go forth the law and the word of the Lord from Jerusalem. He shall judge between the nations and arbitrate between peoples. They shall beat their swords into plowshares and their spears into pruning hooks. Nation shall not lift up sword against nation, nor ever again be trained for war. All you of the house of Jacob, come, let us walk in the light of the Lord. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. We shall remain standing for the reading of the Gospel. The Lord be with you, and also with you. Listen to the good news proclaimed in the Gospel according to St. Luke, the third chapter, beginning to read from the first verse. Glory to Christ our Savior. In the fifth year of the reign of Tiberius Caesar, Pontius Pilate being governor of Judea, and Herod being tetrarch of Galilee, and his brother Philip, tetrarch of the region of Iturea, and Tetrachonius and Lysanias, tetrarch of Abilene, in the high priesthood of Annas and Caiaphas, the word of God came to John the son of Zechariah in the wilderness. And he went into all the region about the Jordan, preaching a baptism of repentance for the forgiveness of sins, as it is written in the book of the words of Isaiah the prophet, the voice of one crying in the wilderness, prepare the way of the Lord, make his path straight. Every valley shall be filled, every mountain shall and hill shall be brought low, and the crooked shall be made straight, and the rough ways shall be made smooth, and all flesh shall see the salvation of God. This is the gospel of Jesus Christ. Praise be to Christ our Lord. Shall remain standing to affirm our faith together in the words of the Nicene Creed found on page 108. We believe in the Lord God in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is, seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, generally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him, all things were made, for us and for our salvation. He came down from heaven, was incarnate of the Holy Spirit, met the Virgin Mary, and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
At this time, we are going to listen to the sermon that is set aside for today. Let us pray. Mazalwane. Heavenly Father, we bless you and we thank you for this wonderful day when, O God, you call us again to be like the forerunner John the Baptist, who proclaimed the Lord, our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, and went ahead to declare that he is the Savior of the whole world. We thank you, Lord, for giving us this day today to come before you, to worship you, and to also get encouragement, O God, to be forerunners of the gospel as we prepare for the return of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. We thank you for the words that have been read. Thank you for the scriptures that we have been given. For through them, O God, we are encouraged, and through them we are also challenged. We pray now, God, even as we are about to hear your word, as we are about to expound your word, Lord, we pray that you may make the words of my mouth and make the meditations of our hearts always acceptable before you, O Lord, our Redeemer. Continue to lead and guide and protect us. Continue, Father, to direct us into your truth, that we may glorify and exalt you in all that we do. This, O Lord, we pray through our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. And I speak this morning in the name of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please be seated, Bazalwane. And may you be greeted once more in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Today, being the second Sunday of Advent, we have our sermon, which is titled Messengers of Christ's Return. And we shall be reminded of our readings. The first reading was from Malachi chapter 3, and the psalm for today was substituted by Luke chapter 1. And we also had the second reading from the epistle to the Philippians in chapter 1. And the gospel reading from the gospel according to St. Luke, the third chapter. And as I have already said, the title of our sermon today is Messengers of Christ's Return. We continue, Bazalwane, with our Advent season, with different things coming up each week to entrench in us the awareness and the importance of the time of Advent. Indeed, we remember that last week, in the first Sunday of Advent, we had a theme that was focusing on the faithfulness of Christ our King, thus assuring us that if he has promised that he is coming back, then we should have courage and faith that he will come back as he has promised, as we have seen him in the past, being God that is faithful over a number of times and issues which he raised and were prophesied and were fulfilled as according to his word. So today's message focus is on reminding us that we have a duty and an obligation to be messengers of the return of Christ. Not only do we expect and await his return, but we are also called to remind the world and the church that we need to be ready for the coming of Christ our King, the King of Kings, who is coming very soon. And this, Bazalwane, unfortunately, is a duty that we cannot afford to neglect or overlook in our lives, but we have to take seriously at all times, as the Bible says, whether it's in season or out of season. Whether it is Advent or not Advent, we need to be reminded that Jesus Christ is coming back. And so with the first reading from Malachi today, we hear the proclamation in the Old Testament that a messenger shall precede the coming of the Lord. As we eventually saw in later readings in the Gospels, how John the Baptist preceded the coming of Jesus Christ, we have also been called to be messengers who are called to declare and decree that Jesus Christ is coming soon to fetch his bride. And the bride that the bride and the world both need to be made aware of this fact that Jesus Christ is coming back again to fetch his bride. And this coming, as we read through Malachi, is going to be pleasing to God, as it did before even. It's going to be pleasing to God because it is going to be a fulfillment of the mandate of God on earth. Just as God fulfilled his mandate in prior years, even now we are told that he will continue to fulfill this mandate of bringing Jesus Christ back to earth to come and bring and collect his bride to rule and reign forever and ever. And so, Bazalwane, as we continue to herald this good news, we are also called to tell the world who Jesus Christ is and who God is and what God or Jesus Christ has done for us and done for the world, so that the world may begin to see that the one that we are expecting indeed is a doer of great and awesome and wonderful things. And therefore, the world will find it easy to submit itself to the kingship and rulership and the truth of Jesus Christ. In what was supposed to be the psalm today, we find what is normally called in the church and used in our morning prayer liturgy a lot, the song of Zechariah, which he declared out as a prophecy when he acknowledged the prophecy of God and agreed to have his son named John instead of Zechariah. And people couldn't understand, why do you want him to be named John? Because there is no one that in your family is called John. But Zechariah knew and understood the prophecies of God that had been revealed to him. And so he was not swayed by the hearts of men and the thoughts of men. And he stood for what was truth. And we are told that even as he agreed to have this young baby brought for circumcision to be called John, he regained the use of his voice, which had departed when he couldn't understand how he, as an old man, could have a child and together with his very old wife. But we live and believe in a God of possibilities. The church today, almost like Zechariah, fails to believe and herald the good news and becomes silent. But as we speak out, as we declare that Jesus is Lord, then our fears are overcome. Even our speech is brought back to us, and we are able to find ourselves and not be a voiceless church, but be a church that will speak out for justice and be a church that will speak out about the power of God, the goodness of God, and the good news that God has given to us. So if we refuse as a church to speak out against injustice, against sin, and against evil, we are making ourselves voiceless and irrelevant in the body of Christ. And so, like Zechariah, we have to speak out and herald the prophetic word from God the Almighty. And so we hear that when the baby was brought to Zechariah and he said, "This is John," and agreed with those who were able to speak, as it has been told to him, we are told that his mouth was able to work again. And we have been called today, Bazalwane, to prophetically tell the world that Jesus Christ is coming back. Let us not be silent. Let us not be voiceless, lest God takes away our voices because we are unable to use them for His power and His glory. And if we fail to use our voices, then we shall be failing to carry out God's mandate, and we run the risk of being found mute until such a time as when we eventually repent and begin to be forerunners of the gospel of Christ, that will speak out and tell the world that Jesus Christ is coming again. We need to declare to the world that Christ is standing and waiting to receive His own people back to Him at the end of time, which is drawing closer each and every day. We need to declare the word to the world that the forgiveness of sins has come through Jesus Christ our Lord, and people are being set free. Captives are being set free. The blind are being made to see. The dumb are being made to speak. And the deaf are even being made to hear through the power of Jesus Christ, who brings life and has promised us that He will give us life in abundance. In the epistle today, Paul highlights his pleasure in the Philippian church because they are sharing the gospel of Christ to the world and to each other. Indeed, God, who began the good work in them, as He says, is going to conclude this good work because Jesus Christ is coming back again. And Paul is encouraging us as a church to remain in Christ, to remain relevant, and remain focused on the work and the gospel of Jesus Christ until He appears. And we are told that when He appears, He is not going to find them wanting, but He is going to find them pure and blameless, and also having a great harvest of souls into the eternal kingdom of God. In deeper Zalwane, we are warned here that we must be careful that we do not find ourselves having lost out, having gone and done so much to work for the kingdom of God and journey with God, and then find ourselves that at the last day when He appears, we do not qualify and are unable to be received by Him. May we always be aware of these things and always be, let them be at the topmost part of our hearts as we think about our eternity and where we shall spend it. In the gospel reading, we then come to hear the voice of John the Baptist calling the people to proclaiming the gospel of Christ and leading many people to repentance. And this, Bazalwane, stands as a bright reminder to us that we have also been called to declare the good news of God to the world and to prepare the way of Christ so that when He comes, the world is going to be ready for Him. We know, we can see the world is not ready for Him because the world is so much so busy with everything else except for the return of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. And so we need the world to be ready for Him, because when He comes, He is coming with eternal punishment. When He comes, He is coming with eternal banishment. When He comes, He is coming with eternal pain for all who have failed to receive Him as Lord and Savior into His life. And the good thing, Bazalwane, is that we are called with love to remind people to also do our best to make them aware that they need to save themselves from this eternal pain, banishment, and punishment by receiving Jesus Christ into their lives. Just as John the Baptist went about proclaiming that there is coming a Savior, Jesus Christ, who will save the people of God. The question is, how much are we doing today to proclaim or to prepare the way of the Lord? As John the Baptist went about preparing the way of the Lord, how much are we doing today to prepare the way of the Lord? And are our own lives prepared for the return of Christ? Because we cannot prepare others and then find that we ourselves have not been prepared for the coming of Christ. We need to look at our relationships with God so that whilst there is still time, every crooked path is made straight, and every mountain and hill and valley is made flat, that we may experience and receive the salvation of God that has been set aside for us. May we continue to declare the advent of our God, the advent of our Jesus Christ. For indeed the signs, as we can look around, are there telling us that Jesus Christ is returning back very soon. We need Bazalwane to be more vigilant. We need Bazalwane to be more active in this matter, in our duty of being forbearers, and to prepare the world that when Jesus Christ comes, they are not surprised, but they are reminded that his disciples did tell us that he is coming back, and his disciples lived as people who were aware that Jesus Christ is coming back. And so I speak in the name of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, that you and I, Bazalwane, have been called to be messengers of Christ's return. And so let us go and tell the world Jesus Christ is coming back. Amen.
In our prayers that are set aside for today, we are going to use form D of our prayers, and we are going to take this time to pray the second Sunday of Advent prayers. Let us pray. O Lord our God, you declared Israel to be your people and brought them out of Egypt. You desired their salvation even when they would not listen to your voice. Since you have called and gathered us also to be your people, open our hearts to listen and gladly submit to your word. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Almighty God, you sent John the Baptist to prepare the way of the Lord, as prophesied by Isaiah, who foretold the Christ. Remember those pastors whom you have called to proclaim your word and to lead your church today. Give them wisdom and courage as they admonish and absolve your people by your word, that your saints might be prepared for Christ coming again in glory. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, you gather your people together in Christ and make them partakers of your grace. Strengthen the faith of those you have gathered into this congregation, that their love may abound more and more with all knowledge and discernment. Lead us to approve what is excellent, and be pure and blameless for the day of Christ. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Gracious Lord, as you call and gather us into your family, so bless the households of this congregation. Bless husbands and wives, fathers and mothers, as they go about their work of strengthening marriage and raising children. Let their love abound more and more with knowledge and discernment, and fill their homes with the righteousness that comes through Christ Jesus. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord of hosts, St. John the Baptist counseled penitent soldiers to go about their military duties according to your will. Remember those who served in the armed forces, teaching them to respect all life and all people. Protect them from harm and from doing evil. Give them wisdom and courage, and grant that they fulfill their duties honorably. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Almighty God, your forerunner prepared the way for the one who is mightier than all, your Son, Jesus. For Christ's sake, we entrust to you those in need of healing, comfort, and rescue. Have mercy upon them. Deliver them according to your will, and strengthen them in faith, that they might be assured of your faithfulness. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Holy God, by the word of your servant, you prepared all flesh to see the salvation of God. Prepare also the hearts of all who kneel at your altar today to receive worthily Christ's body and blood for the forgiveness of their sins. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Out of the embrace of mercy and righteousness, you have brought forth joy and dignity for your people. O Holy One of Israel, remember now your ancient promise. Make straight the path that lead to you, and smooth the rough ways that in our day we might bring forth your compassion for all humanity. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Holy God, you declared that the days are coming when you would accomplish our salvation. And in your time, you caused your Son, the righteous branch, to spring up for David. By your grace, keep us joined as branches to Christ, that we might bear fruit until the day he returns in glory. For he lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. And we shall ask our congregation to rise as we share our peace. Our Savior Christ is the Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and of peace, there shall be no end. Peace be with you, and also with you. And we share the peace of our Lord Jesus Christ together. Amen. Praise God, gives us peace. It passes all understanding. This point in time, Bazalwane, we open page 116 and we give thanks to the Lord God Almighty for the offerings of Bazalwane that they offer, that they give. We give thanks and we pray for the offering here before us, as well as the offering that has gone into the bank account of the church. And we pray that the Almighty God may continue to bless his children and give them abundantly, so that they too may give freely and with a cheerful heart to the word of God. And so we pray together, paragraph number 48, the first prayer. Yours, Lord, is the greatness, the power, the glory, the splendor, and the majesty. For everything in heaven and on earth is yours. All things come from you, and of your own do we give you. Amen. So blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. Through your goodness, we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made, and for us it becomes the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. Through your goodness, we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, and for us it becomes the cup of salvation. Blessed be God forever. We shall use the first Eucharistic prayer on page 117. The Lord be with you and also with you. Lift up your hearts. We lift them to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give God thanks and praise. It is right and indeed our duty and joy, Lord and Heavenly Father, God Almighty and Eternal, always and everywhere to give thanks through Jesus Christ, your only Son, our Lord. Because through him you have created everything from the beginning and formed us in your own image, and through him you delivered us from the slavery of sin when you gave him to be born as man, to die on the cross and to rise again for us. And through him you claimed us as your own people when you enthroned him with you in heaven, and through him sent out your Holy Spirit, the giver of life. And now we give you thanks because the day of our deliverance has dawned. And through him you will make all things new as he comes in power and triumph to judge the world. Therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven and earth, we acclaim you and declare the greatness of your glory. We praise you now and forever, saying, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. May the congregation sit or kneel as we continue with our Eucharistic prayer. Hear us, Father, through your Son, Christ our Lord. Through him accept our offering of thanks and praise, and send your Holy Spirit upon us and upon these gifts of bread and wine, that they may be to us his body and his blood. For on the night that he was betrayed, he took bread. When he had given you thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this and eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. So too, he took the cup, and when he had given you thanks, he gave it to them, saying, drink of it, all of you, for this is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink of it, do this in remembrance of me. So we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Holy Father, with this your gift, we your people celebrate before you the one perfect sacrifice of Christ our Lord. He's rising from the dead and he's ascending to the glory of heaven. Gracious Lord, accept us in him, unworthy though we are, that we who share in the body and the blood of your Son may be made one with all your people of this and every age. Grant that as we await the coming of Christ our Savior in the glory and triumph of his kingdom, we may daily grow into his likeness. With whom, and in whom, and through whom, by the power of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor be given to you, Almighty Father, by the whole company of earth and heaven, throughout all ages, now and forever. Just as John the Baptist proclaimed in the wilderness that Jesus Christ has come to save his people from death and set them free from their sins, even today we proclaim the same message and we say, Jesus Christ is Lord, Jesus Christ is coming, and Jesus Christ is our Savior. Therefore, brothers and sisters, draw near and receive the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for us, and his blood, which was shed for us. Feed on him in our hearts by faith with thanksgiving. Amen. So these are the gifts of God for the people of God. So we conclude our prayer, our service on page 129. Give thanks to the Lord, for God is gracious, God's mercy endures forever. Almighty and eternal God, we thank you, O God, for reminding us through John the Baptist that Jesus Christ has come to save the world and to set us free from our sins. Help us to continue proclaiming the gospel in the same way that John boldly proclaimed the gospel and led people to Christ and led people to repentance and moved them away from their sin. We thank you, Lord, that you have fed us with these holy mysteries, the body and the blood of your Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, and you have kept us by your grace in the body of your Son, the company of all faithful people. Help us, Lord, to persevere as living members of that holy fellowship, and to grow in love and obedience and according to your will, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. And together we say, Almighty Father, we offer ourselves to you as a living sacrifice in Christ Jesus our Lord. Send us out into the world in the power of the Holy Spirit to live and work to your praise and glory. Amen. Now to him who loves us and has freed us from the sin of our sins by his blood and made us a kingdom and priests to his God the Father, to him be glory and dominion forever and ever. Amen. And may the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep our hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his only Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be with us and remain with us always, as we say, Amen. And so, Bazalwane, thank you very much for participating together with us in the service. We pray and hope that you have enjoyed and had a great time together, and we continue to proclaim that Jesus Christ our Lord is coming, and we prepare ourselves for his coming day by day. May you have a great and wonderful week as we continue to exalt and glorify God for all the good and wonderful things that he does for us. May you always remain blessed and wonderful people that you have always been. And may you continue to like and to share our services so that others who might not be able to participate may be able to partake and enjoy the services from home, especially as we see COVID-19 numbers are increasing, so even fewer people will now probably be coming to church. May you continue to worship and serve the Lord despite all these limitations, because God has given us technology to make this a possibility for all of us. Amen. So, brothers and sisters, go in peace to love and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ, Amen.